My name is Murithi Nelson, principal Matinyani Boys High School Kitui. Matinyani Boys High School currently has an enrollment of 1,513 students, up from 617 in 2018. Matinyani Boys has gone through a tremendous transformation since 2018. We embarked on a transformation agenda with the board of management that was led by Nicholas Mulira, a very effective chairman of the BOM. We have done so much in terms of infrastructural projects in this school. Like we started with the multipurpose hall that cost us around 21 million shillings, courtesy of a fundraising that was held in 2019 through the efforts of our former chairman Nicholas Mulira. After that, we embarked on a huge project of a tuition block that is expected to cost about 60 million on completion. It's still ongoing, about 21 classroom tuition block, which is currently under construction. We have also done two new dormitories since that time, 2018. We have also been able to do ablution blocks. We have done a lot of renovations in the school, the labs. We have increased from three to currently six labs within that period of time. Of great importance is the achievement in academics since 2018. We found this school at a mean of 6.2, with only 67 of the young men joining university. In 2022, we were the best school in Eastern Province with a mean of 9.6 and with 100% transition to university. That is 240 boys out of 240 went to university, with the last grade being a B minus. And those boys are doing very nice courses in various universities. Last year, 2023, we managed a mean of 8.1, again with a 98% transition. 262 boys having joined the university also. So, in terms of transition to universities, we have maintained a steady flow. And to us, that is a great achievement because we have made a big difference in the lives of these young people. Matinyani Boys is not a high school, a high-cost school. We reduced the fees from 49,000 in 2018 and brought it down to 40,535. So that we can give access to as many students as possible from diverse economic backgrounds. One special thing with the Matinyani Boys is that it is supporting very many children from very humble backgrounds in Kitui. And to me, that is our greatest achievement. When these youngsters from very humble backgrounds go through high school and join universities and make a change in the lives of their families, in their own lives, and in the life of this country. So that is our greatest achievement so far in this particular school. Like last year, one of the students who would have otherwise withdrawn from this school, we were able to educate him free. And several others also were able to get to finish their high school. We started also some income-generating projects like the banana farm, which is doing very well, and out of that farm, we have been able to educate one child using the proceeds from that that farm. And to us, again, that is quite a big milestone in this school, that the school can be able to educate some of these youngsters even from some of the income-generating projects. We have challenges like any other school in terms of also infrastructure due to the huge enrollments. And as we speak, we are a 10-streamed school, up from three within a period of 6 years. So that has strained quite on facilities, that's put a lot of strain on our facilities. And like now, we require a new dormitory, we require a second bus, we require a school van, and we are in the process of purchasing a school van from the savings of the school. Most of these projects is courtesy of prudent financial management. I think as a board, we decided that we shall prudently manage these funds so that these funds can be of benefit to the people of Kitui. And we have achieved that much. The government came in terms of providing funds for infrastructure, but that funding is not enough. So we supplement that funding with the savings that we make in the school and help to put up a few extra facilities for this school. In terms of our relationship with the stakeholders, I want to say that we were able to develop a very good relationship between the school and the stakeholders. Sometimes we give manual jobs to the villagers so that they can also be part of this school. We developed a casual kind of program for the villagers such that the few jobs that require to be done, we are able to give those jobs to the villagers so that they can feel part of this great school. And they have really honed up the school as we speak. The parents also have a lot of confidence in this school. Like this year alone, we received 493 Form 1s, the largest intake ever. And this is because the parents and the community have a lot of confidence with our school. They have a lot of trust with us. And you can be sure that in terms of discipline, we have been able to keep the boys in very good shape. Character formation is our key thing here. Apart from the grades, we believe that a student requires that good character in order for him to succeed in life. That is why we really push our students to be self-disciplined and to do the best in terms of even community service. You'll find our students engaging in a lot of community service around, visiting the children's home, even cleaning the market and so forth. So this is, to us, a big milestone in terms of character formation, and our students are very different from the rest of the students because they have known the value of being disciplined in this school. They have learned. Spirituality is also another thing that we have encouraged our boys to. We have the societies and the movements, the YCS, the CU, the Muslim faith, they are very strong movements around, and that keeps them also going. And we find that our school is a prayer school, very prayerful indeed. No weapon formed against this school will prosper. Yes, thank you so much, and God bless you people. And thank you for visiting our school.